The National Park Service logo appears with the main title, Bats, Acadia National Park, Maine. Next, a photo of a small bat clinging to a tree. Words appear. Photo by Erickson Smith, NPS.
Bats are an important part of the ecosystem, providing many benefits for humans.
A montage of bats being held by gloved hands.
Science helps us understand both resident and migratory bat species and the challenges they face.
A montage of rangers talking to park visitors and a classroom of children.
The staff at Acadia works hard to educate visitors and local communities about the benefits of bats and ways the public can help support these wonderful yet misunderstood mammals.
A whiteboard reads, "Bats in your backyard. Ranger James and Ranger Maquette." Then a yellow school bus in front of a white building.
We joined education rangers on one such outing to Tremont Elementary School on Mount Desert Island.
A ranger with dark hair in front of a class. Words appear, James Jordan, Education Specialist, Acadia National Park.
I want to kind of get a baseline for some of your knowledge about bats, and we're going to have a little true-false quiz. So here we go. First question. Bats are blind. True or false? True or false? Ooh, sorry. False. It's false. All right. Though most of them don't see in color, they actually have really great night vision, and even during the day, their vision is a lot better than a lot of other mammals out there too, which is pretty cool.
Ranger James holds up a picture of bats.
The rangers also teach the students about threats to bats, including white-nose syndrome.
A montage of hibernating bats. Words appear. Photo by Al Hicks and Jackie Woods.
While hibernating, a fungus grows on bats' muzzles and causes them to awaken more often during hibernation, which uses up their fat reserves prematurely. And since there is no food source during the winter, they starve to death.
A female ranger in a lab. Words appear. Maquette Clark, Education Specialist, Acadia National Park. Then a gray-haired man walks on a path in the woods on a sunny day, carrying gear.
These scientists here in the park are doing ongoing current research to look at the different hibernating and migrating species, so we're trying to get population counts for comparison's sake.
Nighttime, several people walk with flashlights in the woods.
We join park biologists as they partner with a University of Massachusetts graduate student in a mist net exercise in late summer on a carriage road near Bubble Pond.
Bats are caught in a net, then gently removed and studied.
Yeah, if you find a bat in the net, you have to lower the net to a spot where you can take it out. And usually you start by untangling one of the wings and then kind of hold that in close and untangle the other wing and then get the head out.
A bat is removed from a brown paper sack and studied.
Typically what you do is you take the weight of the bat.
5.8.
You measure the forearm length, figure out whether it's male or female.
That's a male.
Male.
You look at the wings to see if there's any damage. At this time of year, you wouldn't be able to see damage from white nose syndrome, but if you catch bats really early in the season, you can do that. So far tonight, we've primarily caught small-footed bats, which makes sense around here because there's a lot of talus slopes and they tend to get like to roost in kind of that rocky environment, and I think we also caught one little brown bat.
The bats are released. Next, rangers in the woods during the day.
Park biologists set up mist nets several times each year.
Nets are set up in the trees. A biologist studies information on a tablet.
And have also begun using technology to monitor bat activity in areas where bats have typically been present.
At night, a blonde-haired woman, with a flashlight headband, sits on a rock. Words appear, Zara Dowling, graduate student, UMass, Amherst.
I'm hoping to catch migratory bats, so I'm thinking in a quarter like this that we're probably going to be going for eastern red bats, but I'd also be happy if we got a hoary bat or a silver-haired bat.
Rangers, wearing flashlight headbands, walk in the woods.
And these are bats that fly thousands of miles between where they spend the summer and where they spend the winter.
So, Zara, pick a bag.
The closed paper bag starts to move.
Oh, whoa, that's a bigger one.
That's
red. This is awesome, guys.
Okay. You're allowed to come back.
Zara removes a bat from the bag.
So if I catch a migratory bat, I'm going to do all the same measurements, but then I go ahead and attach a tiny nano tag.
A white tab the size of a tic-tac with a thin wire.
Basically what you do is you put it between the bat's shoulder blades and you shave a little bit of fur down so that it will stay on better. And then you apply a little bit of glue and stick the tag on. once you have this, you'll have a series of where your bat's been picked up as it flies south.
Zara is specifically studying the effects of offshore wind turbines on migratory bat species. When we understand more about the bat's migration, we can make informed decisions about how to proceed with industrial projects like offshore wind turbines.
Photos of wind turbines in the ocean give way to Ranger James in the classroom.
The education rangers at Acadia include hands-on exercises to engage the students in the scientific process, thus creating more advocates for bats.
Ranger Maquette holds a paper bag. A student places a rubber bat inside. The bag is weighed.
Sorry, Mr. Bat. I'm probably hurting it right now.
Students inevitably ask what they can do to help bats, so the rangers conclude their presentation with a discussion of the ways that people can help.
Ranger James holds up small signs with words.
Protect habitat. Yeah.
Put up a bat box.
You can.
Talk to scientists.
Yeah. Read this one for me.
Bat friendly gardening.
Okay. One more.
Be nice to bats.
Narrator Maquette Kark. Videographer/editor Rhonda Wasner. Additional bat photos Erickson Smith, Al Hicks, Jackie Wood. Thank you, Tremont Elementary School. Zara Dowling. For more information, please visit www.nps.gov/articles/acad-bat-monitoring.htm. The National Park Service logo appears.